Star Wars Trench Run, developed by Infrared 5 and published by THQ Wireless, released in 2009 in the Apple App Store to be played on iPhone and iPod Touch. A version of the game was also playable on StarWars.com. The game depicts the Battle of Yavin, particularly the fateful trench run Luke Skywalker took to destroy the Death Star. With two modes to play, Trench Run is a very short video game. Mission mode has 5 stages, and once they have been completed, they are unlocked in arcade mode. While playing as Luke Skywalker in his T-16 X-Wing Starfighter during the end battle of A New Hope, players encounter dogfights in which they have to destroy TIE fighters just above the surface of the Death Star, evading fire from the turbo laser batteries. The game has players dodging the many constructs within the trench run, while avoiding being shot down by Darth Vader by eluding the targeting computer of his TIE Advanced. The exhaust port stage has players launching a proton torpedo into the Death Star's weak spot for massive damage. The arcade mode allows a player to replay any of these stages, but increases the difficulty with every attempt. The game uses tilt control to further enhance the experience while flying ships. Pushing the left side of the screen enables force vision, which slows the game down and lets you easily target TIEs or slip through some of the narrow parts in the trench. With a small tap on the screen, the player's vehicle will open fire. The 2.0 update added two more modes called Escape and Han Solo to the mission mode. The escape mode has you manning the laser cannons of the Millennium Falcon as you escape from the Death Star after rescuing Princess Leia. And Han Solo has you manning the laser cannons again as you protect Gold Squadron as they fly down the trench. The update also added new ships to be piloted in arcade mode, including a TIE fighter and Y-Wing. The update also added the ability to control the web version of the game with your iPhone or iPod Touch. As of early 2012, the iPhone version of the game was pulled from the iOS App Store.